Hey guys, Roger Peterson here with Toucan Do. I want to tell you a story. A story about Zach. 4 years ago, when I left the pastorate, had to figure out what I was going to become. And one of the jobs I got to bring in some money and to give me some time to think things through was with a company called Groeneveld. I was basically managing a small warehouse of parts. And Zach, good friend of mine I've known for many years, Zach and I worked together in Toucan Do type stuff for almost 10 years now, maybe 11, and still meet with Zach. But anyway, Zach was my boss. And I was grateful for him giving me the job and training me a little bit and helping me understand the job and just sort of let me work. And it was interesting. He knew that it was a part-time, or he knew it was a short-time thing for me. He knew that wasn't going to be my career. There was a really interesting time near the end of... I was there about a year and 3 or 4 months, I think, or maybe a little less than that. And I was talking about starting my own business, and I had done some work in my business, but I hadn't officially started the business, and I wasn't doing it full-time. I was sort of hanging on to the safety net of Groeneveld, working in the warehouse, and Zach and I talked many times about the fears I had of starting my own business and how the fears ran deep, fears that I had begun in my childhood. And there came a day when Zach said, you're done here, go. He kind of fired me. He said, go, make it happen. He kicked the little baby bird out of the nest and started my own business. And here I am with my business and making good money. And I look back to that point as crucial. Zach played a really crucial point in my life because he knew me well and he loved me. And he knew when to do the hard thing and just to kick me out. Men like Zach have played a huge role in my life. One of my biggest frustrations with God is that he didn't bring along a mentor for me when I was young. And I don't want to get into the theological argument of God's sovereignty and his will and my obedience. I just want to make the statement and you let it go, okay? I was frustrated with God that he didn't bring along mentors when I was younger to keep me out of some trouble and some messes and some ugliness that I fell into. Lately, I have had the best of mentors, and they have been the guys around me in my Toucan Do groups, the guys around me who know me and love me and challenge me. And I just want to say thank to you guys. Thanks. I meet with you. I would say I meet with you to help you. The reality is I probably meet with you to help me. And it feels so good to know that I am loved, and I am cared about, and I am known and accepted, and I am challenged. And so thank you to all of you who play that role in my life. Toucan Do is going to go through some changes, and these changes are changes that I'm walking through with several of you. And the one change that I want to just announce now is that Toucan Do is going to sort of just broaden. And it's really going to be about helping men develop relational skills in general. Skills with relational skills with God, with wives, with children, with each other. It's going to be about just men learning to love better, men having healthier hearts, and just having better relationships all the way around. But I just want to thank you guys for helping me to get to this point in my life. I have no idea where it's going to go, but it's good to know that I'm not alone in it. So thank you very much for all that you have done for me and meant to me. I look forward to spending the rest of my life with you and with men like you around me. It's a good feeling. Anyway, thanks for walking with me through these things. God bless you. Bye-bye.